stop thinking for a moment. And what remains? What remains? What remains? Open intelligence, alertness, stability, openness. Open intelligence. Now you've been introduced yourself to open intelligence. It's more open than you think. It's more open than what you think openness is. It's open, open, inexhaustibly open. You know, like the sky, they're vast and expansive, inexhaustible. This is our mind. This is our mind, vast, open, clear, like the sky. No matter if it's rainy or shining outside, the sky remains open, clear, alert. And this is the nature of our mind, whether you want it or not. Whether you want to believe it or not, that's the nature of our mind. And then open intelligence, when we tap into that by the practice of short moments of open intelligence, allowing everything to be as it is. Isn't it so fun to allow everything to be as it is? Like, don't change anything. Don't change anything about you anymore. And don't try to change anything. Stop describing. Even if you like to describe, just stop describing. Today. Just today. See how it goes for you. Stop describing. Stop indulging. Allow everything to be as it is. Even if the stories are so compelling, like you really want to go for it. It's so amazing. It just gives you so many sensations and you love it. Just stop. Stop. Allow it to be as it is. Allow that vital energy to feel as it does. Allow your mind to think as it does. See, it's completely powerful and empowering. I know that for me, in my own experience, that's a commitment I made. And through being supported by the Four Mainstays, I learned to see that this commitment is a complete freedom. Complete freedom to be as I am, to allow myself to be totally negative or totally positive or just bored from all kinds of reasons. But just allow that to be as it is, to have that permission field to allow myself to be as I am every day. Every day. We may have amazing ideas about how to change the world and what to do for ourselves, for our family. But if it's not rooted in open intelligence, it will never bring immediate benefit. It will never bring immediate benefit because it never deeply felt and enlivened by the power of open intelligence. So fear, for example, I always try to avoid fear. I mean, I didn't like to feel afraid. Fear of loneliness, fear of being myself, fear of people, of meeting people. Just everyday life fear. Fear of what will be the next thing that will come up in my mind. What will I do? Fear of everything. I cannot name it. Fear of everything. And then allowing fear to be as it is. For example, fear. We face fear every day. Look at what is happening in the world. Of course, we all feel afraid. We don't know what will happen every moment. So then to have that open intelligence as completely open, vast, and to rely on open intelligence for short moments many times, I gain confidence in allowing fear to be as it is and being unafraid in the midst of fear, allowing myself to be afraid but at the same time completely stable and open like the sky. I know it sounds weird, but it is like that, open like the sky. And then, you know, like the color blue is inseparable from the sky. So that's the fear, inseparable from open intelligence. It comes through your instinctive recognition of that. When you take these short moments of allowing everything to be as it is, you see it in yourself, that it's unavoidable. It's inescapable. It's like whatever you do, whatever you think, you see open intelligence, open intelligence, open intelligence shining everywhere. That's why the four mainstays are amazing, because in the community, you see that so obviously in everyone. No one is running away when you're afraid, or when you're angry, or annoying. You can be completely annoying. It doesn't matter. Everyone will just remain stable. You can come completely depressed and sad, but then everyone will just remain entirely open to you, loving you. That's, for me, that was something to get used to. I was not. It's not, you cannot underestimate that. But being here, it's obvious. We're all powerful. We can allow ourselves to be as we are, and people will allow that too. So in terms of politics, we support those who wants to support the benefit of all. So instead of, you know, just keeping it very simple, for me it's like that. We support those who are open to support the benefit of all. That's what we see. Not thinking about what kind of ideas they have, and just if they're willing and open to support the benefit of all. And then with our own example of relying on open intelligence, we stand up. We stand up, we do it together, not relying on one person, relying on open intelligence for the benefit of all. And that's the difference, that's the shift I see in my own life, not seeing myself as the only person in the world who can make a change. You see, seeing myself as indivisible from everyone. In allowing myself to be as I am, I allow others to be as they are. I let others to feel the way they feel. Allow all the data to come up in myself, allowing others to have data too. Data is everything. Thoughts, emotions, sensations, experiences. Just allow them all to be completely free, completely free. You see, there's nothing we can do. There's nothing we can do, nothing we need to do. No effort of living our life, and non-effort of being of benefit to one another. It's so natural to us to love, to be together. Not in a cheesy way, you know, powerful, like completely powerful. Our body, just the example of our body, of our speech, it's just totally elegant, beautiful. So that's the way we're supposed to be. The way we are. It's the way we are, truly. I promise you. I promise you, I mean, you all know that too. You all, most of you, relying on the four mainstays, you see it in yourself. So it's just that habit to believe that data has power over us. Data has independent nature. We want to go there because sometimes we want to be a victim. I know that for myself. Sometimes I just want to be a victim of my data strength. Admit, I want to be a victim. Who else is admitting? Just want to see ourselves as victims. I know. Then we get all the hugs and all the, maybe a cake we're going to get after. But... And it's fine too, you know, it's fine too to see yourself as a victim, but then maintain open intelligence. Remember open intelligence. Or God, if it's for you God, then fine. You know, open intelligence synonymous with God. But then, and for me, it just opened up to my own direct experience of saying, what is the meaning of God? What is the true meaning of God in my own experience? What is immediately beneficial to everyone? So then if it's for you most comfortable, then let it be as it is and gain confidence in the power of open intelligence, which is innate to you. No one can give it to you. No one can take it away from you. We own that power, all of us. No one more, no one less. What did I say before? Ah, yes, victim. So we give up the right to be a victim. How do we give up the right to be a victim? We rely on the four mainstays. You know, if even if we don't want to, we rely on the four mainstays. I know that for me, that's a commitment. That really made a shift in my life. Because seeing all the things I resisted and I have doubt about or confused about, I empower myself with letting it be as it is, and I do it with the four mainstays. So the short moments of open intelligence, repeated many times, but uncontrived way, effortless. Whenever you remember, you take a short moment. Today, things will come up along the day, even now. Remember taking a short moment, so easy, so simple, powerful. A short moment of allowing it to be as it is. And then repeat that as often as you want to or remember to. And these short moments, they go longer in a powerful way. They suddenly expand and expand and expand inexhaustibly. And then you just open and relaxed and powerful again. Not completely relaxed that you're just sleeping. you're relaxed and potent, powerful. And my help, okay. And able to make changes that are really effective, bring immediate benefit to yourself and others, to your family, to yourself, to your friends, to everyone, to the world, all at once. So it's not one at a time, it's all at once. That's the power of short moments of open intelligence, all at once. Seeing the benefit in yourself and seeing the benefits in others. And then being with people in a powerful way, seeing people as powerful. It comes like that, it's just so natural. And then the trainings, today I know we have a one-day training, introductory training, right? So then you're most welcome to get to know the training, to hear about the four mainstays, to hear about the language of open intelligence. Even if you don't understand, I know I didn't understand the beginning. Still there are words in English I don't understand, but it doesn't matter. You come and you recognize open intelligence with complete perceptual openness. So the one-day training, all the trainings are so powerful because they evoke the power of recognition and assurance in yourself, not in someone else, in yourself. That's how it was for me. Commitment came about naturally, with the support. And then the trainer, it's a very special relationship to have. It's a relationship that is not casual. It's a very empowering relationship where you see yourself as you are, where you see yourself as open intelligence and you have the opportunity to clarify everything about yourself. So that's very few words about this relationship, but it's indescribable. And the community is very precious. It's a demonstration of all of us together, standing up for the benefit of all, living together, truly for the benefit of all, truly. Not making up ourselves as someone beneficial. Demonstrating that in our everyday life, in every moment, entirely available to be together, to be open and to serve. So that all is available for every one of us. Every one of us. And then at one point, you don't care what kind of data you have, really. Because you feel so supported and assured in open intelligence that you know it will increasingly become obvious in your own experience. You have so many friends, like even if they're not next to you, you feel that community instinctive to you. You feel the four mainstays support powerfully, indestructible.